Now look at this practical switch. Tell me, a practical switch, this is A and this is B. Tell me, for a practical switch, if I close a particular switch, tell me, what is the on state voltage? Will it be 0 or not equal to 0? Tell me, if I close this switch, tell me what is the on state voltage? Is it equal to 0 or not equal to 0? You just tell me. Why it is not equal to 0? Tell me why it is not equal to 0? Why not equal to 0? Yes, sir, I can accept. Not equal to 0. Why? What is the reason? Yes, drop. Drop is there, or some loss is there. That drop is due to what? Some internal resistance or not? That is due to some internal resistance. Every device in this universe will offer some internal resistance or not? Yes. Now, this drop is called, it is not equal to 0, no? It is not equal to 0 means some finite number. Finite number means, tell me, that drop is known as what? That drop is called which drop? On state voltage. On state voltage drop. Or we can call it as a forward conduction drop. Or we can see it as a forward conduction drop. Are you agree with this? This is on state voltage drop, or you can call it as a on state conduction drop. Is it clear, everyone? Yes. Now, let us see here. Tell me, previously, your ideal switch is carrying how much current? You tell me. Previously, your ideal switch is carrying how much current? Ideal switch. How much current it is carrying? Ideal switch is carrying infinite amount. But tell me, your practical switch, is it possible to allow that infinity current? Is it possible to allow that much of infinity current? No. So definitely, there is some minimum limit. There is some maximum limit. Can I say that? Yes. Now, you tell me one thing. During on state, what should be the power loss? What should be the power loss? In previous case, you got power loss as 0. If you remember that. Previous condition, power loss is 0. But existing case, is it power loss 0 or finite value? Is it power loss is 0 or a finite value? Finite. Can I say power loss is not equal to 0? Power loss is not equal to 0. Yes, sir. Minimum or finite value. Both are correct. Now you tell me, I already told you, these losses are called which losses? Conduction losses. Now you tell me, conduction losses are finite values means, what is the energy loss during on state also? Is it 0 or not equal to 0? Conduction losses, is it 0 or not equal to 0? Energy loss. Yes, sir. Finite. Keep as it is during on state. Now, we will apply the same concept for open switch also. Tell me, for an open switch, could you please tell me, this is my A and this is my B. Could you please tell me, what should be the off state current? What should be the off state current? Is it 0 or not equal to 0? For off state, switch is open. Look at the arrow, switch is open. For off state, current is 0 or finite? Current is 0 or finite? Or you can say not equal to 0. Anything is okay. Can I say finite number? Even the switch is open, the current flowing through the switch is not equal to 0. Am I correct or not? Even the switch I opened, the switch is still carrying current. Yes, sir. Off state current is also not equal to 0. Can anyone tell me what is this current is called? During off state, even though switch is open, still your current is carrying current. Means that particular current is called which current? Leakage current. Amazing, Saurav. Very good. That is leakage current. Very good. Shika, very good. That current is called leakage current. That current is called leakage current. Tell me, what is the voltage limit? Can I apply any amount of voltage, or voltage limit is there? Tell me. Can I apply any amount of voltage or any finite voltage is there? Any amount of voltage or finite voltage? Yes, sir, limited voltage. It means I have some minimum voltage. I have some maximum voltage. If I have a minimum voltage, if I have a maximum voltage, yes, sir. that residual current is you will get in electrical machine. This is called generally leakage current. Leakage current. Do you know about leakage current? Even though switch is open, it means suddenly if the device is turned off, it means in your house, for example, on and off switch is there. Suppose a fan is rotating. A fan is rotating with some speed of 1000 RPM. Are you getting my point? A fan is rotating with the speed of 1000 RPM. I have a switch. Tell me, if I switch on, your fan will be continuously rotate. Correct or not? Now suddenly if I switch off that particular fan, tell me, have you observed any spark at that particular switch or not? Have you observed any spark? Yes, that spark is due to leakage current or ionization of air. I will discuss this point at the end of the lecture. Okay, mark this point. At the end of the lecture. Yes, while switching off only. At the end of the lecture, I will discuss this point in a very clear manner. Okay, mark this point. Shall I go further? If it is okay, I will clear this down at the end of the lecture. Please let me complete this concept now. Yes. Now you tell me, if leakage current, if off state current is finite, voltage is also finite. Tell me what is the power loss? What is the power loss during off state? Tell me, respond. Come on. What is the power loss during off state? Finite. Yes, can S not equal to 0? Yes, very good. Now, if power loss is not equal to 0, then tell me what is the energy loss is also? If power loss is 0, energy loss is also not equal to 0. Is it clear, everyone? Till this point, is it clear, everyone? For a practical switch, when it is on, when it is off. Tell me, this loss is called which loss? Come on. Which loss? Blocking loss. Perfect. That is called blocking losses. On state losses are called conduction losses. Blocking state losses are called blocking losses. Please note down. I will show you the safe operating area where you need to use this particular switch. Shall I go further for safe operating condition? Yes. Thank you. Now, let us see what is the safe operating region. That is a very, very important, huh? Safe operating region will give you at which instant you have to operate your switch. This is my current. This is my voltage. And this is my voltage. Now, you tell me one thing. For this case, power loss is a finite value or zero value? I need an answer. Power loss is a finite value or zero value? Tell me. Power loss is finite. Whenever if power loss is a finite, heat will produce or will not produce? Whenever power loss is finite, heat will produce or will not produce? Only one answer. Heat will be produce or not? Yes, heat will produce. Whenever if heat will produce, you require cooling arrangement or not? Yes. Cooling arrangement is necessary. Now you tell me, if any device is producing a amount of heat, finite amount of heat means you want to operate any amount of voltage and current or finite amount of voltage and finite amount of current? Again, I'm asking, if any device is producing some amount of heat, whether it is a finite value or 1 watt or 2 watt or 3 watt, 1 watt or 2 watt or 3 watt, tell me, should I operate any amount of voltage and current or finite amount of voltage and finite amount of current? Yes, finite amount of voltage. See, this is my finite amount of voltage, finite amount of voltage, finite amount of current, finite amount of current. So, look at this dotted line. Have you seen this window? I am putting names A, B, C, D. So, tell me what is the boundary limit of your particular switch operating? conditions. What is the boundary limits for your switch operating condition? Tell me. Boundary limits. Boundary limits. So within this limit only you have to operate. Beyond this you should not operate. Tell me which is the boundary limit for this particular switch to be safe to operate. Yes sir. Come on. Yes sir. ABCD. Within ABCD. Yes sir. Within ABCD. But still I have one question. You tell me. Just general question I am asking. You purchased a motor. For example, I am considering. You purchased a motor whose power rating is, rated power rating is 10 kilowatt. Are you getting my question? You purchased a motor which is of rating of power is 10 kilowatt. Which is a power of 10 kilowatt. Tell me, you want to operate exactly 10 kilowatt or less than 10 kilowatt or more than 10 kilowatt for safe operating of your motor. It means your motor should not get damaged. You want to operate above rating or below rating or equal rating? Hello Saurav, if you operate above the rated value, then what will happen? Your machine will get overheated, huh? Machine will get overheated. So machine will get damaged. So most of you are answering about less than the rated value. Less than the rated value. Now you tell me one thing. Why you are not operating 100%? That is my question. Why you are not operating 100%? Is there any reason? Because I have a 10 kilowatt. If I operate more than that, my machine will damage. But if I operate at a 10 kilowatt, nothing will happen. Or will happen or will not happen. Someone is saying safety factor, power factor. Okay, next. For safe operation, yeah, for safe operation only I'm asking. For safe operation only I'm asking, will you operate exact 10k or less than 10k? If it is a less than, if it is a exact 10k, what will happen? Efficiency balanced. Efficiency balanced. In that only you have your answer. Can you tell me, is there any machine without losses? Is there any machine without losses? If there is any machine without losses, means I will purchase that machine for any application. So definitely there is a small amount of losses will be there. Then who will supply that losses? For example, if you operate at 10 kilowatt, suppose if you are operating at 10 kilowatt, what amount of losses will produce? For example, if it is a 10 kilowatt means, can I say some 1 kilowatt, let us assume worst case, 1 kilowatt if it is a losses, 1 kilowatt if it is a losses, tell me what is the overall power generated by the machine? Overall power generated by the machine now? Overall. If you operate it at 10 kilowatt. Yes sir. More than 10 kilowatt. Then tell me what is the resultant power generated by the machine? Is it more than rated value or less than rated value? More than rated value means machine will get? What it is going to be? Burn, or it will get heated, or windings will get damaged. So for this reason you want to operate 10 kilowatt or less than 10 kilowatt? Less than 10 kilowatt. See, understand here. See, learning about switches is not an important thing. But where you have to use, at which point you have to use, that is a very very important point. See here, less than 10 kilowatt. Tell me, if this is my boundary condition, now I cannot use this full load current. Why? Because if I use full load current, I will operating at full load power now. See here, can I say this point is nothing but maximum voltage into maximum current? Am I correct or not? You tell me. If I take A point, is it nothing but the maximum voltage and maximum current? Is it correct? Similarly, look at this point. Is it maximum voltage and maximum current? Are you getting my point or not? Maximum voltage, maximum current. Is it maximum voltage, maximum current? Maximum voltage, maximum current. I told you already, you cannot operate at 10 kilowatt. You have to operate less than 10 kilowatt. Therefore, should I consider this current? This current, or should I consider less than this? You tell me. Should I consider this current? I mean, at this point, or should I consider less than that? Very, very good. You have to consider this less than. But voltage? Yes, again I am repeating, please don't miss this point. See, 10 kilowatt. 10 kilowatt power rating is there. Will you operate a 10 kilowatt? You want to use 10 kilowatt motor? 10 kilowatt rating power? 10 kilowatt rating power? No. You want to operate at less than 10 kilowatt or not? You want to operate less than 10 kilowatt? You want to operate at less than 10 kilowatt? Yes. Less than 10 kilowatt means, suppose if this is a maximum voltage and this is a maximum current. Product of maximum voltage and product of maximum current. Product of maximum voltage and maximum current will give you maximum power rating or not? Product of maximum voltage and maximum current will give you maximum rating. But already you told me that, sir, don't operate maximum current, operate less than rated current, less than rated power. But you tell me why I'm not using this current, why I'm using this current? Are you getting my point? Yes. Now you tell me, power loss or heating loss due to voltage or current? Can anyone tell me, power loss is due to current or voltage? Everybody should answer, not even one person, everybody. Power loss is due to current. Yes, remember one thing. Power loss is due to current means, can I maintain rated voltage? Power loss is due to current means, can I maintain rated voltage? Yes or not? Yes. So that is why I will still maintain this rated voltage, but I will reduce the current. Are you getting this point, everyone? Similarly, look at this side. I will maintain the same rated voltage, but I will use a reduced current on all the sides. I will use reduced current. Now, can I say, look at this area. So, have you seen a window which is cut at edges? Have you seen this? Are you understanding this point? Have you seen a window which is cut at the edges? Have you seen? Yes. So now, where is your safe operating point? Can I say within this particular window? Are you getting this point? Can I say within this particular window, can I operate this? Yes, sir. This is my safe operating. Yes, I will repeat the last part. Last part means, see here. Why I have taken as a less current? Why can't I take a less voltage? Tell me. Why I am not taking as a less voltage? Product of voltage and current should be less than this rated value. It means, for example, 10 kilowatt means, suppose 10 ampere. Are you getting my point? 10 ampere is the rated value. 1000 volts is the rated voltage. Okay. Now you tell me, what is the product of this? What is the product of these two? 10 ampere I am considering for this motor. 10 ampere and 1000 volt. What is the product of these two? 10 kilowatt. Now you tell me, losses due to voltage or current? Losses, is it due to voltage or current? Current, na? Now you look at the board. Previously, this is my 10 amperes. Are you getting my point? This is my minus 10 amperes. Are you getting my point? Yes, sir. Now this is my 1000 volts. This is my plus 1000 volts. Now you tell me, I want to operate my motor in a safe operating region without overloading means, you want to reduce the current, you want to reduce the voltage. You want to reduce the current? To reduce the power rating, operating power rating. Tell me, which one you have to reduce? Current or voltage? Only one point. Current or voltage? Yes, current means, so current decrease means here or not? Less than 10 means this is. Am I correct? Both are correct or not? You tell me. Sarav, quickly. Is it less than 10? That is also less than 10. Yes. Now you tell me, corresponding current is nothing but this point and this point and this point. This point. These are the corresponding points or not? You tell me. These are the corresponding current points or not? These are the current points. So that is why I am considering within this particular window. Still, is it clear, everyone? Yes. Have you understood? Have you understood? Perfect. Now, just I will give you very brief conclusions of your switches, classification of switches. Just listen. Okay. Now listen. Ideal switch operating region is, tell me how much, what is the duration of ideal operating region? Operating region of ideal switch. It means safe operating region of ideal switch. Infinity. Infinity amount of voltage and infinity amount of current you can flow. But strictly speaking, tell me for practical. You want to apply infinite amount of current or finite amount of current? Or infinite amount of voltage or finite amount of voltage? Yes, sir. Come on. You want to operate finite amount of current and finite amount of voltage. Due to what reason? Tell me. Due to what reason you want to operate a finite amount of current and finite amount of voltage? Due to power loss. Which power loss? How many power losses you will have for a particular switch? How many power losses you will have? Yes, heating issue. How many power losses you have? How many power loss? Two power loss. One is conduction loss, another one is blocking loss. So you want to operate at rated condition or you want to operate less than rated condition? You want to operate rated condition or you want to operate less than rated condition? Less than rated condition. Why? Due to only one reason. Why? Due to only one reason. Less than rated only. Why? Losses. Perfect. Vikash. Perfect. Due to losses only, na? We are operating less than that. Suppose if there is no losses, yes, I can operate exactly 10 kilowatt. But definitely losses will be there, na? Switching losses will be there. Some copper losses will be there. Due to that particular reason, I cannot operate at rated value. That is why I am operating within this particular window. It means, if you choose any voltage, if you choose any current, any voltage, any current. Tell me one thing, your switch is in safe or not? Your switch will damage or will not damage? If you choose any point within the safe operating region, your switch will damage or will not damage? Switch damage. Safe. That is why these operating points are called safe operating points. These operating points are called safe operating points. These are called safe operating points. Shall I go ahead? Have you noted down this safe operating region? Have you understood this example? Okay. Shall I erase this? Yes. Yes, listen. Now, I'm asking you a very simple question. So many of you know this. How many of you know about circuit breaker? Circuit breaker. I think most of you know about circuit breaker, right? Circuit breaker will have one fixed contact, one movable contact. Is it correct? One fixed contact, one movable contact. Tell me one thing. If any fault occurs, how this will be operated? How the circuit breaker will operate? Will it circuit breaker open or close? When any fault occur, circuit breaker will open? Yes, very good. If any closed contact is there, means still, I told you already, practical switch, is it carrying some energy or no energy? Practical switch, is it carrying some energy or no energy? Yes, carrying some energy. It means it is something energized or not? Energized or not? Yes. Now, if I suddenly open this breaker, if I suddenly open this circuit breaker. Yes, previously let us assume a current is flowing, say suppose 10 amperes of current is flowing. 10 amperes of current is flowing. If I suddenly open the switch, tell me, due to this flowing of current between these two, some air will be there. Between those two contacts, some air will be there. Yes, due to this air, some current is flowing. And electrons will try to flow, but actually the flow of current is moving from this side to this side. Is it correct? But what you are doing? You are interrupting the flow of currents. If you are interrupting the flow of currents, tell me, already this part is energized or not? This part is energized? Yes or not? Respond. This part is energized? Now you tell me, any energized part, but if you suddenly open, see, this is, look at this marker, see, if this is energized, if I suddenly open, the air will get ionized or not? Ionization of air will take place or not? That ionization of air will produce some arc. Are you getting my point? That ionization of air will produce some arc. Generally, we will call it as a spark. For that arc quenching, we will use some SF6. Like gases we were using. Some SF6 gas we will use to quench that particular arc. That air ionization is called due to leakage current. That is called what? Leakage current. Yes, arc quenches. That leakage, that arc which is producing, that arc is also called leakage current. I hope you have cleared, Ashwin. Yes, of course, depends upon switch rating. For example, if the switch is carrying 10 amperes, it can bear only 10 amperes, some plus or minus 2% tolerance will be there. If there is more than 10 amperes, this switch will get damaged. That is why you have to design a particular switch based on the requirement. If more the rating of the switch, it can block the more current. It means even if you open the switch, the arc is going to be very less. If more the rating for the same current, if rating of the switch is less, current is more. If you suddenly open the switch, what will happen? Huge spark you will get. I think, is it clear? Vikash, Ashwin. I hope your doubts are cleared, right? Somewhat, sir. But there is a difference between arcing and sparking. Am I wrong? No. Arcing and sparking, there is no much difference. Why you will get spark? Tell me. One fixed contact. If you see in your home, you have a switch, just to turn on the bulb or to rotate the motor, you have a switch or not? Tell me, there you are closing the switch, there you are opening the switch. Is it correct or not? You are closing the switch, you are opening the switch. Is it looks like a circuit breaker or not? Switch is closing, switch is opening. Are you getting my point? Yes. If you suddenly open the switch, means can the same situation will happen? Right? So, with this, our classification of switches are over. In the next lecture, we will see about various problems, how we will solve our problems by using shortcuts without investing much time. Okay? And we will see various devices like diode, thyristor, MOSFET, BJT. We will see in detail about that in the next lecture. Okay?